Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website, that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for October 22nd of 2021, well, it is titled A Comet and a Crab. So what do we see here? Well, here we see a view of space towards the constellation of Taurus the Bull. And a couple of things that we see there, down towards the lower right, the greenish glow is actually a comet known as 67P Churyumov-Gerasimenko. And that is an example of a comet, and it's actually a very well explored comet, and in fact is bringing a robotic craft from Earth back into the inner solar system, because the last time it came by several years ago, we had the Rosetta spacecraft in orbit around it, which is now part of that comet. It has actually crashed into the surface, so it is still there and will remain there. And as the comet now comes back in. Now, the actual nucleus of the comet is completely invisible at this scale. It's far too small. However, what we do see is the coma, the greenish color, often due to carbon emission in the halo around the comet itself, and then the tail stretching back up and maybe slightly to the right, stretching back up there. The tail is caused by particles being pushed back by the sun. So as material is excluded from the surface, it is then pushed back by the solar wind and the radiation pressure of the sun, creating a tail for the comet. So this one is coming in again. It will not be a very prominently visible one. It's not a super bright comet, so you will not be able to see it with the naked eye, but you will be able to see it with a small telescope or a pair of binoculars. Now, the other object mentioned is the crab. The crab is up towards the upper right side, and you can see that fuzzy reddish patch there. And that is what is known as the Crab Nebula. And it is the remnant of a star that exploded over almost 1,000 years ago. Back in 1054, it was seen to explode here on Earth. And since then, the material has been expanding outward till it reaches a size that we see in our image today. So that is 1,000 years worth of expansion as it spreads out into space. Now, it is also known as M1, Messier number 1, and that was the first object that Charles Messier cataloged in his catalog of objects that were fuzzy in the sky but were not comets. So as comet hunters were looking to find comets such as the one we see down towards the lower left hand side, they cataloged other fuzzy objects which did not move among the stars and were actually something much more distant. So Messier's catalog includes things like supernova remnants like this. It also includes star clusters and other nebulae as well, like star forming regions such as the Orion Nebula, and even galaxies such as the Andromeda Galaxy are all part of this catalog, which was just done for objects that were not comets. So that was our picture of the day for October 22nd of 2021. It was titled A Comet and a Crab. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture. So until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.